Stasiak. Full arm drag and twist now. Bottom wrist lock. Lateral takedown, head scissors, Stasiak back on his feet, and a slight trace of a smile crossing his face that may have belied how he was feeling inside, because Donovan moving away from him very nicely. High hip toss that time on Donovan. Donovan now eyeing his man carefully. Stasiak keeping Donovan tied up. Back to the ropes. And Stasiak, a short chopping punch to the head. You could see the effect that that punch had on Chick Donovan. That's exactly what we were talking about with this man, Stasiak. Whether it's a long punch or a short punch, this man has tremendous power. Stasiak continues to punish Chick Donovan. Again, that fist traveling about 8 inches, and Donovan was down. And Stasiak continues to punish Donovan. Donovan, who's a wiry, determined competitor, going up against a man who has a great deal more experience. Wow, another clubbing right hand to the head of Chick Donovan. And again, Donovan dropped to the canvas. And how many of those he can take, it remains to be seen, but he has taken, at this point in time, tremendous punishment from Stasiak. I understand, too, that Stasiak has schooling Ox Baker regarding the heart punch. You can picture what kind of a tag team combination they'd make, Stan Stasiak and Ox Baker. Donovan hurtled from the ring. And Donovan catching that on the base of the spine. Coming up very slowly. Stasiak closing in again. Another clubbing right hand. Donovan again outside on the concrete floor. Donovan trying to get it together outside the ring. And again, Donovan caught on the head, Stasiak. When he smiles, it's almost a grimace. Donovan, up and over his man, gets him in a rolling reverse. Stasiak, powered away from him, and Donovan firing away. Donovan, exploding. Ooh, caught that time by Stasiak. So Stasiak, stunned momentarily, suddenly retaliates, hooks that hand, going for that heart punch, caught him. Caught him with the heart punch.
Stasiak driving Cruz down to one knee, back up. They lock both hands together. And Stasiak, the heavier and taller of the men, drives Cruz down. Cruz coming back. And a kick to the midsection, the move made by the veteran Stasiak. Cruz again down on one knee, trying to power his way back. Gets up for a moment, catches a knee lift to the midsection. And into the ropes. Stasiak throws a punch right to the chin on the ropes and sends Art Cruz flying. Cruz through the ropes and out on the concrete floor. Cruz back in and turnbuckle treatment all the way across the ring to the near neutral corner. Punch out of the side headlock. There is the bell. I do believe we've had
a... Stasiak is a super genius.
He's a mental pygmy. Yeah, that thing says Mecca. It doesn't say Mensa. I mean, Stasiak may overpower Spike Dudley. And we can see why Stasiak, what a magnificently gifted athlete, physically gifted. His father, a former WWWF champion. And Stan the Man Stasiak. But Stasiak is just, unfortunately, he's just not real bright.
Well, Stasiak right now showing that Spike Dudley may not have too bright of a future because Stasiak is taking out the bully of Dudleyville.
And by the way, if you just joined us later tonight here live in, from Toronto, The Rock will defend the coveted WCW Championship against the hometown Christian. 1-on-1 here, of course. And look at the power of Stasiak. Not to mention, Paul, that huge tag team matchup that's been signed for tonight.
Y2J and the returning Jeff Hardy taking on everybody's favorite superstar, Rob Van Dam, and the Man Beast Rhino.
Over 18,000 on hand here tonight. We mentioned it's this event sold out in about an hour and a half when tickets went on sale. And as a result of that, we're going to be back here tomorrow night. Matter of fact, SmackDown will be live on UPN and on The Score in Canada tonight. And there's a trick by Stasiak.
Spike trying to kick Stasiak. I can't believe how much of a bully is Spike Dudley.
Don't make yourself look bad, Paul. That did not happen. You know it didn't happen.
Are you saying that Stasiak did?
And who tripped Stasiak?
Molly just tripped Stasiak.
The bully got a laugh out of it. It's Spike Dudley with the Dudley ball. Oh, this is a huge upset.
Chuck Palumbo joins us at the broadcast position.
Well, why don't we get someone over here?
Who's going to do the
commentary too? We get some headsets for this guy.
Probably Mark Jindrak over
Mark
as well.
Jindrak, how you doing, brother? Stevie Ray, nice to meet you.
There's a headset for Jindrak as well.
That thing, it's broken. The headset's broken. Go back over there, Jabroni.
Hey, but watch your partner's back. I'll take care of this, all right?
Hold the phone. You know how much those headsets cost?
Tony Jabroni, shut your trap. I don't care how much they cost. Send me a bill, would you?
John Stasiak against Sean O'Hare. On one here. Two of the teams that are going to be represented in that four-way elimination for the Tag Team Championship at New Blood Rising.
Well, I'll tell you right now, Palumbo and Perfect Event, they don't have a chance. They have no continuity. They do not work together. They press around like third graders too much. And if they were in the ring with me and my brother, Harlem Heat, they wouldn't have a chance.
Harlem Heat.
Ten times World Tag Team Champions,
right.
Palumbo.
Tony
DeBrone, wisdom.
Time out. Stevie, see that Harlem Heat sign over
get
there?
Get your hands off me, man.
Do you see the Harlem Heat sign?
Where is it?
I don't see it either.
That was not funny. Meanwhile, Shawn Stasiak and Sean O'Hare will go at it here one-on-one. Chronic still the World Tag Team Champions. But will it be that way a week from Sunday? 1-2 at New Blood Rising.
Hell no, it won't.
So much can happen in a match like that with four tag teams involved. Chronic's going to have eyes in the back of their heads to keep their focus on all the opponents.
See what I'm talking about? The guy just made a good move, and he sits around and presses around like a six-year-old in ballerina school.
That's because he's just that damn good. He can do that. Remember, we're the perfect event. There's a couple of Jabronis like those green guys in there. You got blue, and you got yellow, and together they're green.
Well, Tony, do I have to sit here and listen to this?
You do not, because you're cool.
I'm trying to stay cool.
And also, let's also make mention of the fact that the Perfect Event always seems to have this illegal object wherever they go.
The only reason we have those is to pump up before the match.
The match.
With bodies like this.
Then leave them in the dressing
room.
You
want to pump them up. No. We take them to the ring.
Okay.
Yeah, and you use them on your opponents. We've
Never.
Seen that on many occasions.
There's a pickup by...
Today, you need to mind your own business.
That's...
Palumbo, you calling the man a liar?
Oh!
Yes, I am.
What a big time!
Come on, O'Hare.
Come on.
O'Hare, come. If he can make the cover right here, this match would be over.
Sean O'Hare made it through the WCW power plant in a mere 6 months. And now,
he's not even ready for TV. What are you talking about?
They have, in a short span, become one of the top
teams. He's so green, he's blue.
Oh, come on. This kid is so gifted athletically. 20 years training in the martial arts, a third-degree black belt, a pro boxer before joining WCW.
That's right.
Green.
And to the ropes goes Stasiak. Oh, here it's the ropes.
He's got Stasiak blue right now.
That's an illegal
because
move.
He's got him blown up.
That's an illegal move.
Scoop slam. Down goes Stasiak. Get up the cup.
Right hand over the top.
Well, I tell you, you can see that O'Hara has a lot of fire, a lot of vigor, and a foot into the chest, and down goes Stasiak.
That was a front kick, martial arts style. This guy must have a martial arts background of some sort.
I just told you, 20 years training in martial arts.
Get out of here.
I didn't.
You know something? I think I'm going to sit down in this chair. I'm going to take his head off.
What do you mean?
Wait a minute.
Bring him over here, Sean.
He's picked up the Lex Flexer.
What are you?
Come on.
What are you
bring
doing?
Bring him over here. I think I'm going to chop his head off.
Hold on now. Wait a minute.
Stick his head off.
Stevie, leave it alone. Easy, man. Sit down, man. Stay down.
Jeez, big. Oh.
Sit down, man. Just leave. Why don't you stay here?
Holy smokes.
What an intimidating force our new broadcast colleague is.
I like having him here. Meanwhile, in the ring, it's Palumbo's down. Two Northern Lights!
Oh. Hey.
Hey, I thought you were going to be cool.
Hey, man, that was cool.
You're not kidding, it was.
Can't deny that. He is cool. Well, I like having him out here.
You look good on your back.
We got a time to do over here, and I'm tired of people coming over here trying to rough stuff.
Get out of my face.
Palumbo's never looked so good.
No, I know that. Meanwhile, in the ring. Wait a minute. Jindrak is up on the apron. Isn't it great? He can take care of our back here while we call the action. Up on top. Shot ahead. Oh, what a kick that was.
Sit down, Palumbo.
Meanwhile, as Stevie Ray tries to get situated again, Sean O'Hare's up on top. On the top turnbuckle.
Big
shot.
Oh, yes.
Bomb.
Oh, yes.
And a cover. One, two, three.
The Showtime Bomb on the top. We'll be right back.